Hello everyone, I'm Dragon Whoop and welcome back to FortressCraft Evolved. When we last left off, I was trying to get biomass to the surface. Well, let's consider myself lucky and my mission successful. I got it working. I also hooked it up to a large storage container unit, mass storage area, I got two outputs going into the one line. And I got it set up to where the biomass goes directly into my vat over here that makes tons and tons and tons of high energy composite fuel. As you can see, this line right here is the line that the biomass is coming through. I also have it set up where iron comes through here. This is a pipe extruder plant. This turns iron into pipes, sorry. And then once this is done, what is this? That's a lithium pipe. Why are we getting lithium in this line? We should not be getting lithium in this line. I'll have to fix that. Where is lithium coming from? There's iron. Iron lithium. Okay, that's a weird thing to happen. There's iron. They're all set on remove only. Wonder why that happened. I don't know. I guess I'll just have to keep an eye on it. Okay. Regardless, we got it set up to where the pipes are automatically made. And it goes into the system over here. And it goes into the fuel canister crafter, which turns those iron pipes into empty fuel canisters, and the empty fuel canisters are fed into the vat system over here. Also, we also have the empty ones, because once the fuel is inserted into the jet turbine engine or the generator, once it empties its fuel out into the system, it releases its empty fuel canisters back into where you can reuse them, which is very, very nice. Which I'm very, very much enjoying it of that. So I don't really need like a bunch of these. I could probably set 100 or so and have them in constant flow, remaking. So all I would need then would be a constant source of biomass, which since we have the conveyor system coming up from the surface, or the conveyor box, the conveyor lift, we have all that coming up. So it's nice, pretty nice, huh? But another thing that this high energy composite fuel is used for is for making missiles, which I've already started doing. And today we're going to actually complete this process, probably get it a little bit more automated. So I thought this would be a nice place. I was starting to dig this place out up here for kind of like a missile silo type situation, because this is where my missiles are going to be. As you can see, I already got two of them set up. And we have tons and tons and tons of high energy composite fuel coming up through here. And this is making the rocket parts that it needs. And this is filling it up with, the missile fueler is filling it up with the high energy composite fuel. So the empty missile assembler needs both gold wire and copper tubing. So I have a pipe extruder here and a extruder plant here. So I put like, I can go ahead and demonstrate this. I put gold in here. It will sit there and it will extrude that gold into wire, and this wire will go into here. And then the empty missile assembler will take both pieces and put it together and make Empty missile. Empty missile assembler makes empty missiles. And yeah, and then once this is done, if the empty missiles are fed into the missile fueler, and it takes this and it makes this, and we get the lovely missiles. We have 65 basic missiles so far. And this is for when we get bosses, or I think it also targets the larger enemies, like the heavies. I think it targets the heavies as well. So it's just, I was thinking about expanding this out further. I mean, you can expand it out as far as you want. But I was trying to think of a little nifty way to get missiles to multiple missile launchers or missile turrets, but I don't think there is without actually either manually doing it or setting up some type of like assembly line, kind of like, you know, setting up this with another hopper or something. I don't know. They do require power, the missile turrets. They do require power, so you have to make sure you supply them with power. This power is coming in from the bottom down there. Let's see if I can open it up. Yeah, there's a laser that's coming down from the bottom. So, and it's all being powered by the jet turbine that we have running. Over here. Let's go up here. See, I have all these batteries under here. Let's see if I can get up there to show you. Oh, yeah, be careful. Don't get into the jet turbine's afterburn, because it hurts a lot. But what I did is I went ahead and crafted some organic power systems, organic power storage, because I had the pieces to do it, and it holds 8500 power. So that's pretty much what I did. And then I have where is that line coming from? I have one line going down into the big system just in case. You know, it's just like a backup. This is going to be a backup. And also put some power storage blocks on top, which are sending energy to our fueler system up there for our missiles. I'm just going to leave that system up there running. I'm going to leave this pretty much running. And I'm probably going to work on something else. I don't need that all these lithium pipes in here. I need to rid this line of lithium. And I guess the best way to do it, it looks like there's only a few bars. I don't even know how I got in there. Okay, grab that. Actually, let's just grab all of this so it would fill up, and grab the lithium as it passes. There we go. And if we continue to see lithium in the line, I'll probably need to troubleshoot. It's like once every so often. All right, looks like I weeded all the lithium out of the, yeah, looks like I weeded it all out. So now it's just a matter of finding out where the lithium is coming from. But if I haven't showed everybody, this is my nifty little alloyed machine block automated thing. What I did is I made the mass storage system import titanium, gold, and nickel. It goes into the system. Once it's imported into the system, it is then exported. I do this because I don't want it to back up. I guess it really doesn't matter. I probably could straight line this. That's probably what I'll do. But anyway, you have your nickel coming in this way. You have your titanium, your titanium coming in this way. And then I have a zipper that makes sure that it is equally distributed into this storage hopper here. So as you can see, it's 50-50. There is a hardened machine block thing under here, which makes hardened machine blocks. I then branch this off to, I can make hardened machine blocks here if I just needed a regular hardened machine blocks. And then from here, If I didn't need regular hard machine blocks, it would then send the machine blocks into this system. Then it will make it into the alloyed machine block. And then this is where the gold comes in. The gold travels along this way. This one's full. So once it gets 16 machine blocks, 16 gold, it makes the alloyed machine blocks, which I need a handful of. Go ahead and grab. And I want to make some Mach 3 storage containers. Or, let's see, am I running low? Yes, I'm running really low on those. So what I want to do is I want to turn some of these into the energy laser transfers. So I'll get about 10. And then I'll turn the rest of them into, well, not really the rest of them. 20 Mach 3 storages should be decent. And then we can save the rest of them for whenever we need it later. So I'll throw my hardened machine blocks in there. And throw those in there. Oh, goody, 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 goody. We got two of the perfect faceted eyes. So now we can turn that into the lenses that we need. The two organic lenses. Craft. And does anybody remember what we needed those for? I kind of do, but I don't really remember offhand. I know it had to do something with... Is it the energy board? No, that's one that. Basic quarry? No, still need parts for that. Nope. Apparently it wasn't that important if I don't remember exactly what it was. I mean, I know that the using two perfect faceted eyes is used to make the energy lasers. Ah, the spider cannon. There we go. Okay. So we can actually make the spider cannon now. I was trying to do that last episode and couldn't because I didn't have the parts. But I do have the titanium coils and the plastic pellets. So we can actually make the cannon now. Yeah, craft the cannon, and I want to place this right there so I can input it. This would be his input hopper here, be remove only, and put it in there. He should be coming back. Yep, since he was defending, now he's coming back, but our system is taking care of all the bad stuff. But he's coming back to get his little gun. And I probably should go collect the spoils. Yeah, there's a bunch of stuff on the ground. And if anybody remembers the geological survey that I put up here a couple episodes ago, it's still finding stuff. So this is where we're going to put our quarry when we can make one. Which we should probably start looking into making one quite soon, because it's going to allow us to get a lot of resources quickly. I mean, really, really quickly. I'm also going to set up a kind of basic macerator system. So that way, all the blocks that, like dirt and snow and rock and rough stone hewn block and all that other stuff, will be put into a macerator turnabout and pretty much turned into ore itself, so that way we have lots and lots and lots of ore. Oh, he's got his cannon now. Look at that, he's pretty cool, and he's pretty good at defending too. And he's like, he hasn't even touched any of his lithium cores from a couple episodes ago. I still have a bunch of them in there. But now that we've got that complete, now it's time to work on something else. I don't really know what else to work on. I was thinking about trying to upgrade this system, but I don't think it's implemented yet. I unlocked the advanced cargo lift. But when I went to look through to it, or went to find it in the recipes over here in our research terminal, I couldn't find it. Unless it's something that I need to actually you know, like grab. So the next thing on our list, though, is trying to build and power a orbital transmitter, so we can actually get beam the power up and the series to be done. That's the end game stuff. You want to make sure you power this. But before we do that, we're going to need the ultimate power, because the ultimate power is going to allow us to get not only the Mach 2 solar panels and the Mach 2 organic solar panels, it's also going to allow us to get the Mach 5 battery. And that Mach 5 battery, it is massive. I mean, massive. So let's actually go ahead and start it. Why not? I mean, we probably, let's check all the other ones first before we get too hasty. So ultimate, the power for the spider bot defense, what does this do? It gives the spider bot particle rifle. It's a shoulder mounted particle rifle that are capable of dealing heavy damage to the very largest of targets. They are independently targeting and intelligent and ignored smaller. Okay, so that's pretty much, are we getting that type of threat? 1800 basically. So no, we're not reaching the boss level threat yet. So we can hold off on the advanced spider stuff. Ultimate power grid, that's the next. Rolling stock is pretty much making use of minecarts. The minecart tracks, basic minecarts, minecart slopes, things of that nature, where you could put a minecart. That's probably what I'll do for the missile system up there. That would be cool. Have it the missile fueler and the missile assembler feeding a storage hopper, where a minecart comes around, picks up the stuff, and then goes around to the hopper where the missiles are and drops it off. That might work. I'll have to do some research into that. All right, the next thing to do would be basic rocketry. So what does this do? You can master more pretension fuel. It needs a fuel compressor. What is a fuel compressor? Compresses carbon particles with the high energy composite fuel to generate an extremely volatile and enriched fuel source. Built in a 3x3 configuration. I wonder if it's something like enriching coal. It's like you have the basic enricher, which does a certain things, and then you have, or these are the basic enrichers over here. You take your coal, which is probably like our biomass, and then you turn it in and say, okay, I want to enrich you, make you better. And then you put it, you can throw it in there and it generates more power. And then there's probably something later on that's going to be like, okay, you can take the compressed fuel and turn it into more compressed fuel. So we'll look into that. I mean, it doesn't look like it's that expensive. It looks like it just takes 512 biomass. That's easy. I have that on me now. So let's actually look into that. Let's do that. I think I have the power. So let's just do basic rocketry. Start. Open up our, yeah. Do 100 at a time. Maybe we can actually just watch this if we want. So be right back when it's done. Alright, now that it's complete, we can take a look at what it gave us. Apparently, we don't need to research it. That's good. So, see if I can find it in here. Thank you. There we go. Fuel compressor needs 5 hardened blocks, which we have plenty of. There we go. Is that only one? All right, then we'll just go to where I have it automated set up, automatically set up to make them, and just grab some. There we go. Got 100. Nice. And let's make the fuel compressor. All right, let's take a look at this block. I'm pretty sure it probably needs power, so I'm gonna place it next to a battery over here. Oh, it needs to be in a 3x3. Fair enough. So we need 3x3x3, so we need 9. So let's just make 9 of these. Or we made 10. Probably need a couple of them for later uses, but just for demonstration. So 1, 2, 3. There we go. Oh, need more. So apparently we need, what, 27? So it means we're going to need some more hardened blocks. Yes, we're going to need a lot more hardened blocks. So tell you what, I'm going to start making these hardened blocks because we, between when we left off and I cut, we ran out of nickel. So I have to go down there and actually check to see about getting some more nickel. Unless there's some more hidden blocks around here that I could go ahead and snag. Let's see, do we have any here? There's 14 there. Let's see, how many is left in here? There's one. Because we only need, like, what, 7 more blocks? Not too many more. And we have 3. And we're out of nickel. So I'm going to go ahead and call the episode there. I'll get between episodes. I'm going to go down and make sure we have a ample source of nickel, so that way when it comes time for me to finish that up, it'll be done, and I'll teach you all about the fuel compressor in the next episode. So thank you everybody for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please give it a big thumbs up, and until next time, see you later.